Sid, Alexa. The only three names that matter. Bernie and Sid in the morning.
Now on Echo Devices.
77 WABC.
What an amazing job. Heshy Ogenbaum, our dear friend, Maimonides Medical Center in Brooklyn, and his son, Josh. Josh is a guy that put together... I first got pictures last night from my dear friend Corey Zelnick, but now Josh has tweeted pictures of the convertible Corvette, 2019 Corvette, which is plastered with my face all over it, and Sid Sports Sunday, and Bernie and Sid, and the fact that I'll be an honorary Grand Marshal. What a job by Josh Ogenbaum, Bernie, decorating this car, which I guess will be driving right in front of the big float. For Maimonides coming up on Sunday. It is, of course, the 55th annual Celebrate Israel parade, and all of New York gets involved in this one. Don't have to be Jewish. Andrew Cuomo, who was not there at 9/11 yesterday, Bill de Blasio, Curtis Sliwa, everybody gets involved in this one. Michael Miller.
Chuck Schumer.
He'll be there.
Oh, no doubt.
100%. Yeah. Michael Miller is the CEO of the JCRC, our second guest from the Jewish Community Relations Council in the last couple of weeks. They pretty much run this major event coming up on Sunday, and he's here this morning to join us. So, Michael, good morning. How are you, pal?
Good, Sid. How you doing?
We're doing great. And listen, let's get right to the most important question of all, which is, it's an annual event. It is a huge event, one of the more popular parades all year in New York City. But really, what is the major significance about this parade?
Thanks for the question, Sid, because this parade really represents the warm relationship over the decades, over the five-plus decades since we started this parade, of the connection between New Yorkers and Israel. There's so many ties between New York, both personally, commercially, all different kinds of ways, certainly with regard to travel, and tourism, and of course, for those who are religious, whether you're Jewish, whether you're Christian, whether you're Muslim, there are connections to Israel as well, historically and spiritually. So this parade is representative of all of that, and that's why we have 40,000 marchers marching up the avenue.
And of course, Sid mentioned a few celebrities. I should say politicians, actually. Schumer, de Blasio, Cuomo, will they be there indeed?
Indeed, they're going to be there. They've been there in the past. They'll be there on Sunday. Every other top elected official in New York is going to be there, too. And this is a tradition in New York, very similar to other major parades that we have here in the city. This is one of the top parades, as Sid indicated. And the politicians want to be there. Other celebrities like yourself, Sid, are going to be there, too. We're really thrilled, and thank you so much for participating.
Now, this is one of the biggest honors, really, of my lifetime. When Heshy first called me about this, I was blown away. I was floored. And I am, of course, an honorary Grand Marshal, Michael. I found out there are three of us. There's one Grand Marshal, the Big Macha, and then there's three of us, the honorary Grand Marshal. So who are the four people, which does include me, that will have this honor on Sunday?
Okay, one of them is Ted Comet. Who is in his 90s. I think he's 96 years old, and he was the founder of the Celebrate Israel Parade 55 years ago.
Wow.
When it didn't exist. You imagine just stepping into a vacuum and saying, we need to have a parade here in New York. It started on the far west side of Riverside Drive, and now we're going big time over the past, who knows how many years, 50
right.
years or so,
yeah.
on Fifth Avenue where you're going to be. We have Siggy Flicker, who is...
You got to be kidding me. Siggy Flicker, my friend from the Real Housewives of New Jersey?
You got it. Absolutely.
Oh, my God. You know, listen, both Tenafly natives at one point, both Boca Raton natives, same restaurants, same friends, and both of our 8x10s up in the Tenafly Diner.
Really?
Yes.
Unbelievable.
How do you like that?
You never know. You know, we're all connected one way or the other, but that's an extraordinary connection. And then also joining you is Leo Leibovitz and Stephanie Butnick, who are the co-hosts of a great podcast called Unorthodox. As you could well imagine, since in our faith we have Orthodox Jews, well, these individuals view themselves as being unorthodox. Very cool, and we love to have them in the parade as well as honorary Grand Marshals.
Will you have the SpongeBob float by any chance, Mike?
Hey, listen, I understand the weather's going to be great for Sunday, too, on top of it all.
With your blessing, it's going to be great.
Yeah, right now they're actually calling. That is the one day they're calling for showers at some point, but supposedly late in the day after
that's
we're done.
Right.
So, you know, whenever we have these big events in New York and especially parades, Michael Miller, the CEO of the JCRC, the question always is, I don't know who pays for it. Who funds this? So who does fund the Celebrate Israel parade?
This parade costs about $1 million in order to produce, and we have donors from all across the Jewish community and non-Jewish community who support us. We do get a major gift from the UJA Federation of New York, for which we're very, very grateful. Pretty much it's the floats, it's the marching groups, and it's just regular people from New York who really believe in this and want this parade to happen. And of course, we're going to have a significant delegation there from the State of Israel, led by the outstanding Consul General, Ambassador Dani Dayan, who I hope you get a chance to meet, Sid.
Oh, he's an impressive guy. The ambassador to the UN, I believe.
We have two Donnies. Dani Danon is ambassador to the UN,
right.
And Dani Dayan is the Consul General here in New York. They're both terrific representatives of the State of Israel. We're really blessed to have them.
You know, one thing, Michael, we kind of joked about last week, Bernie and I, but we really weren't joking. There was a guy that was arrested here last week, and he was talking about doing all kinds of horrible things, you know, shooting up parades with Jews and blowing up the Israeli consulate and killing Donald Trump because he likes the Jews. And the guy was out of his mind. He was crazy, but for example, I'm going to be riding in a convertible, and somebody in my family actually joked, well, this is a JFK waiting to happen. Again, they're just joking, but there are some security concerns. Anytime you have that many Jewish people, even in New York, in one place, it does bring on a little bit of an anxiety, no?
I appreciate that, but again, we've been having this parade over the years where there unfortunately have been terrorist threats over the past 10-15 years or so. We work hand in hand with the New York Police Department and through the police department with the Joint Terror Task Force, which includes the FBI and a lot of other law enforcement agencies. If you want to be safe, probably the safest place to be is on Fifth Avenue on Sunday between 11 and 4 p.m.
That's right. Well said, of course, Michael. And also, they're going to the Empire State Building will be blue and white. The lights will be blue and white, so they're going to celebrate that. The colors of the Israeli flag, of course. So it's going to be a great day.
It will be, and your participation in it makes it even greater.
Yes, even wearing a Joseph Abu design for me, you can't make this up. I'm wearing white linen pants and a light blue Abu sport jacket.
All right.
So I'm going to look like the Israeli flag and the Empire State Building as well. Hey, listen, Michael, thank you for all the great work you do with the JCRC, and you and Charles, we did a great job here last week as well, and really very excited to meet all of you on Sunday. This is going to be a magnificent event, and thank you for making me a part of it. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We really appreciate your involvement, Sid. And last week's interview with Charlie was outstanding. And I'm really honored to be part of this program as well. And look forward to seeing you on Sunday.
Sounds great. Michael Miller is the CEO of the JCRC. And once again, now, Bernie, you said it's on Channel 9. And all the same folks as Channel 5, Robert Moses and Baruch Shem Tov will be out there. But it starts at 10 o'clock on TV?
I don't know what time. 11 a.m. is the official start time to the parade.
Okay.
So I would imagine sometime shortly after that.
Okay.
Or at least before that.
All right.
11 a.m.
All right. There you have it. Channel 9 coming up on Sunday. Well, we'll take a short break when we get back. The Mets out in Los Angeles last night and game one of the NBA Finals. The Blitz is coming up next.
Bernie and Sid in the morning, 77 WABC.